Hello, Enterprise students, families, and friends, and happy Art Monday. Last week, I shared a video and asked you to join me in a self-portrait challenge. This week, we are going to focus on making our own materials to use at home. If you head to the Enterprise Art page, you will find this week's lesson on using different materials in place of paint that we normally use in the art room. But right now, I'm going to show you how to make your own Play-Doh or modeling clay. I found this recipe online, and I chose this one because it only uses 3 ingredients, and you probably have them in your kitchen. Now, I could have practiced this before, but I thought it might be fun for you to see me make it the first time. I hope it works, but remember, if it doesn't, try again. It's all about having fun and getting creative. So here we go. To make our modeling clay, you're going to need flour, you're going to need salt, and you're going to need water. Those are our 3 ingredients. In order to make it, you'll also need a mixing bowl, you'll need some measuring cups, you'll need 1 cup, and you'll need 1/2 a cup. And you'll also need something to stir with, or you can use your fingers. Now, I recommend doing this maybe either outside or in an area that's going to be okay to get a little messy. First, let's go ahead and add, I forgot my trusty glasses. Let's go ahead and add 1 cup of flour. Off a little bit. That looks good. And dump it on it. Then you will need, you can either use this again and fill it halfway, or you can also get 1/2 a cup. And you're going to get some salt. And you're just going to fill it right over. And you're going to dump it in too. Okay, and you just want to give it a little bit of a stir. And let's go ahead and add our water. You're also going to add 1/2 a cup of water. And dump it on it. That's it. Let's go ahead and give it a stir. Gets a little too dry, you can go ahead and add just a little bit more water to it. I think I'm going to need a little bit more water. And I'm just going to take the cup and add a little bit. Once again, remember, if it doesn't turn out right the first time, go ahead and give it another try. Now, I'm using a fork, but you could also use your hand. This looks good. Just gonna ball it up here. It's a little too sticky. I maybe added a little bit too much water. So if you do that, okay, you kind of see it's getting a little sticky here. If you maybe add a little too much water, go ahead and just grab maybe a little pinch and sprinkle some flour on it. I know some of us didn't get to make or even finish our clay projects this year, so I thought that this would be a fun alternative. All right, once you get your ball, you can use a flat surface to go ahead. I'm just going to put this down. And you can see it's sticking a little bit. And maybe just sprinkle a little bit of flour on your surface, kind of like your baking bread, so it doesn't stick. It also feels really good in your hands to play with. See? Right now, we have our modeling clay, or Play-Doh, or salt clay. And you can just break it up into pieces, and you can go ahead and you can start to shape it. All right? I'm trying to make my little heart here. I don't know if you can see it. What I can do is, if you want to make it hard, I can go ahead and you can put this in the oven at around 200 degrees for about 30 to 45 minutes. And it should dry out during that time. Once it dries out, it's going to be hard. And then you can go ahead and you can use markers or you can use paints if you have them to color it in. You can even make another self-portrait if you want. Now, if you are lucky and you have food coloring at home where you can get some, you can also go ahead and add a few drops of coloring, food coloring, into your dough to go ahead and give it some fun colors. But if you add the coloring in, just remember that it might get your hands a little colorful. And that's how you do it. So in order for me to store this in here, I'm just going to stick it in this bag. I can play with it a little bit, and then I can come back later on and play with it again. You can store it in your fridge or on the counter. If you store it in the fridge, it will probably last a little longer. Okay, well, that's all what I have for you today. And as always, stay creative, stay safe, and don't forget, Mona.